Hi guys, in this video I show you how to overhaul the hydraulic cylinder in the front section of the roof, locking the roof if it's leaking and overhauling without disassembling from car. This is a huge saving of time and I support this video to you. Also, I'm no native speaker, no native English speaker, but I think this content could be interesting for a lot of American and English Mercedes SLK enthusiasts. If they struggling with the issue of repairing this cylinder. Typically you see this on leaking, on moisture inside of the roof. If you look upward, if you look upside, so the first thing you have to do is to manually unlock the roof as I show here. If you pull these ribbons after loosening the cover, you unlock. And though you can bring the it's called comfort roof, you can bring it in a maintenance position to work at. It's a manually opening of the roof. I used my little smartphone endoscope, boroscope. You can get those items for about $12 or $15, just to look where these strings, these ribbons are located, so you don't pull at the hydraulic tubes. Okay. At this side of the lock, I show you this mechanism just for understanding, and I had to disassemble it because the ribbon went away, broke, and so I had to disassemble in a different way. This is typical, like a belt buckle. How do you say lock? It's similar to a belt buckle lock. This line you see, we call it Bodenzug in Germany, is connected with the hydraulic cylinder of the hatch, the rear hatch. And if this cylinder is going to be activated, first thing it does is unlock this part, so the hatch will open and take the roof inside. Okay, here I show once again that the boroscope I used to be sure to pull at the right line. And so if both sides are unlocked, like here. Just let me say one thing. Care for your fingers, because you're working at hydraulic systems. They support enormous forces, enormous power, and don't get your fingers between this mechanism. Very dangerous is one guy is working at the system and one guy is pulling the button. What I missed here, what I didn't show, is you have to loosen at the hydraulic pump this screw, this brass colored screw. This is behind this cover I show here. If you don't, you would you probably will destroy the pump. Okay, here you see once again it's free now. The mechanism is free now. Notice, please, once again, this is similar to a belt buckle. Okay, here's the pump. Here is that screw. You need an Allen, I think 6, and don't unscrew it too far. Maybe just a bit more than half a turn, not as much as I do here, because also here will be the danger of a malfunction of the pump. There are so-called O-rings inside, and these O-rings could slip away. Okay. I secured the hatch by this carton piece, so it don't come down. And now we start to move the hatch into a maintenance position, like I showed. In the next video, you will see that the work isn't done completely after overhauling the hydraulic piston. We have to go deeper in, but in this video, we show the normal way of overhauling the hydraulic piston. As I'm be told, the black one SLKs are typically more often affected by failures of this hydraulic cylinder, because they are directly under the roof, and if the roof is black, a higher temperature will occur under the roof. Here you see the inside, the gray. It's like fabric, and it's by moisture, by hydraulic liquid moisture. So next step is to loosen the roof mechanism, and look exactly at my left hand. This is the right place, and maybe you should hit it with the amount of power to open. Make it exactly like I did. This is the experience of 3 cars. And also lower the triangle screens before. There is a video where I show how to do if the system is dead. But here we go. Here you see once again the moisture, and now we loosening this inner cover to get access to the hydraulic cylinder. Okay, after loosening this 3 screws, there are more screws in this part of the cover. This is an extended version of the work to do for the repair of the hydraulic cylinder. I don't make these videos for the experts, for these guys knowing exactly what to do. I try to encourage people with ambition to repair the car themselves. And that's the case. I show every step as good as I can. Sorry. Okay, there's another screw in this, how do you say, link area in the rear part. And once again, please work carefully. No guarantee for injuries. Don't get your fingers between these two halves of the roof. I suppose you're gonna lose them. This is really dangerous area. Be careful. Maybe lock the roof somehow with some tape and blocks of styropor. As I show it here, it's not the best way to do. Careful your fingers. At least hold the mechanism by one hand if you get with your fingers in this gap. So here you see once again maintenance position. And now we disassemble the inner cover. I use a tool like this. Be carefully. These plastic parts are about 25 years old, and they lost a lot of their okay, we say elasticity in German. And there's another screw. Use exactly fitting screwdrivers, please. So you really can loosen these screws. Last one. Best way are magnetic screwdrivers. And now carefully pull it out. Once again, the topic of this video is how to repair the front hydraulic cylinder without disassembling it completely from the car. This is a very time-saving method. The equipment is supported by company RSC, German company, and I think they will ship to overseas too. So I show the other side from another angle of view, and it's four times as fast as in reality. This is a extremely cost and time saving method. To make the hydraulic system working again and having fun with topless driving. Okay, here is the inside cover once again, completely moist shot by hydraulic liquid. And now we're going to start to disassemble the hydraulic cylinder. The pressures in these systems usually are about 160 bar, German unit bar. For mention, oil pressure will about will be about, in an ancient will about 5 bars. So very, very high pressures. And here is the cylinder. I show you just the old one. You see the ceiling, it's hardened by the heat of the sun, about 25 years, by the heat of the hydraulic fluid itself, to bring the fluid under pressure, will result in higher temperatures. Okay, but now first we have to disassemble it, to unlock two of these safety washers. I don't know how you call it. These washers are locked with the bolts, and I would recommend use one finger to hold it, because if they jump away, there's a lot of searching inside of the car necessary. Sometimes you don't find it. This is Torx. You need Torx tools before you start with working. It's, I think, a T30. Yes, T30 exactly. 3 bolts.
T30.
Lose them. Here we go. Now the cylinder is free, and you can push it backward to get access. Before, you have to unlink the hydraulic tubes at 2 or 3 fittings inside the roof to get it far enough outside to work at. You also need some of these model builder high revolution drills driven by 12 volt. Don't try with a normal drill. The revolutions are too low and you can't drill exactly. Why drilling a hole inside of this cylinder? It's because you need to get a securing ring out of a groove, and I think there is no way to get it out without this hole, but you're gonna see soon what I mean. First of all, unlink the hydraulic lines and be careful not to injure these lines, to destroy them, because if you do, you have to go the whole yards. You have to disassemble everything backwards to the hydraulic pump to change the complete cylinder with its lines. We try to avoid. Everything in this area is wet by hydraulic liquid. And now you have to fix this cylinder for drilling. Okay. I took a rolling bench, a bench with wheels below and screwed this blue thing, we call it Schraubstock, on this bench to fix the cylinder. Just a second, you soon will see what I mean. The battery you see I use for running the drill, and here once again the parts from RSC company, and no, it's not burning, this is just my cigar. There is not only a new piston rod with new sealing, with a more improved material. There's also, as you see, I show here a special tool to pull out the old cylinder. Here you see the new piston rod. And in the background is the cylinder fixed and prepared for drilling. I drilled maybe half a millimeter too far back. So I show the measuring gauge. And you get just half a millimeter more forward than me. So it would be more comfortable. This is my first try to get this securing out without drilling, and believe me guys, it didn't work. Next try, I show it to you so you can avoid this and start directly with drilling. Okay, you see, no chance. If you send the old piston rod to RSC, if you don't scratch it, you get about, I think, 80 euros back, not sure, or 50. If you scratch it, they give you, I think, about 20 or 25 euros back. Okay, and now we use my most favorite toy. This is from Procon, but you can get it from other companies too. It's a high revolution drilling machine for model builders. They are not too expensive. So if you don't have one, buy one. You will need it more often. And if you drill the hole, turn the drill, span it again in the drilling machine, and try to press out the securing the fixing ring. Try to press it out from its gap, from its groove. I do it the first time, so I am the pioneer for you, and if you look my video, you will be prepared for this job, and I wish you a good doing of this job without complications. So a different view. Here you see this fixing ring.
Oh, umgekehrt.
And now you're gonna understand why we need this hole. We can press out, push out the fixing ring through this hole. Now you see as it moves. Okay, here we go. The ring has moved, but not enough to get it out of the groove. You see these little numbers on the tubes, these red numbers. The pump itself is there is every hole, every port numbered 2. So it's easy to change the whole pump, and you will in the next video see we have to change this pump. This happens often if you repair at the hydraulic system one part, one item, another will fail. And so wait for my video. I show how to detecting a powerless pump. She did some opening cycles and then collapsed. And I show you how to detect. There's an easy way. Okay, there's the ring. We made this experience with the SL of my friend Harald too. We changed the big one lifting cylinders, then the front ones collapsed, and so on. At least we changed every one of the cylinders. Okay, this is the special tool from RSC company to pull out the old piston rod. Presented with the new piston rod with the new sealings, and you have to pay an amount of about 80 euros, and you get this back if you send the tool back. Very nice company. Thanks to Mr. Moreno. He helped a lot.
Sieht man.
Okay, here we go. It's a spanner, 10 millimeter. And now we pull it. It takes a little time, but it's not as time consuming as to disassemble the whole cylinder with its lines back to the pump, loosen it at the pump, and disassembling all of the plastic covers and all that stuff. Just some seconds more, and we're going to hold the old cylinder in our hand. Here it is. And you see that the blue part is the ceiling. This part is sealing the hydraulic pressure of about 160 or more bars. And it's doing a hard job, and it did it about 25 years. Here you see once again my arrangement for doing the job. With the battery for the drill machine. The drill machine itself, like I said, Proxon. But there are others too. If you're doing only this one job, I think the cheapest will make it. Okay, here I show how I secured the roof, because I left the stuff till the next morning to go on this work. And once again, the destroyed by fatigue, materials fatigue, sealing. It should be one part, and you see it's cracked. This is the case why your roof don't open. Yeah, and a whole sequence won't start if this hydraulic cylinder don't works, because may you see from a angle of your eyes, at the left and right lock there are micro switches, and if you push the switch to open, and this first sequence of of this cylinder, it don't opens the locks, the lockings, so the micro switches won't be activated, and the system stops immediately, don't going on, because they don't get the okay. Locks of roof front are unlocked. Okay, clean that cylinder by liquid, a brake cleaner, and don't go inside with a tissue or something like that. Just let it running out, because the most tissues,
6,
they are contaminating the inside surfaces.
Okay, I showed you once again the size, where to drill. And now we rebuild it. I used a bit of grease. Better is hydraulic liquid. No, don't use the grease like I do. Use hydraulic liquid. And here is the appropriate, do you say appropriate? Hydraulic fluid. I would recommend buy it from Mercedes. It's not so expensive, at least in Germany. No experiments at this place. Use the hydraulic fluid with the correct specifications. And use it for assembling. The next issue we are facing is to get this green thing into the hole, because you see this round going lip spreading outside. This is what it should do to seal against the hydraulic pressure, but it's not an easy way to get it out. I tried with different methods, but believe me, the best way is like I show here, with a flat screwdriver going around, pull it inside section for section from 12 o'clock to 0 o'clock, go round. Don't destroy it. Be carefully. And with much patience, suddenly it will be inside and sliding in. No easy job. These hydraulic systems are very interesting. As you know, I'm also an enthusiast of vintage aircrafts. And if you go to meetings, to air shows, sometimes it happens that a landing gear, retractable landing gear, won't come out or won't get in. If you're looking inside the, how do you say, gear, landing gear bay of, for example, a P-51 Mustang, and you see all the hydraulic cylinders and tubes and all that stuff, you can imagine that there is sometimes a malfunction, because it's a lot of work to keep it all in shape. This is only one cylinder, and it's cost expensive. This is another stupid try of mine, didn't work, and there's only lasting this method with the screwdriver. or maybe you take a plastic part, a special one. It's maybe more better. Hard part of plastic. So the change to hurt this ceiling is not that high. Okay, now we almost made it. You see, it's almost inside. Don't give up. Never give up. If I see the video, the tension is coming up again, but now we made it, it's inside. It's fixed. And then next you have to slide the black washer to and then clip in the securing clips. I did two things to protect the piston rod. First, I covered it with tape, and second, I pushed this ring over at the end of the piston rod where no functionality is needed. Here we go. If you plan to buy such a car, such a R170, check out inside the cover if there are traces of liquid. The cover itself should open without any hesitations. If not, there is an issue in the hydraulic system. Okay, after I protected the piston rod, I push this black washer in a bit more deeper, just to get access to the groove. If you push it a bit too far, this is no problem. The hydraulic pressure will push it back against the secure ring. You should plan about 2 or 3 hours to do this job, maybe 3 hours. If you have no garage, 3 hours without rain. Now we have to get this ring inside, back into its groove. First try, no good idea. Don't do like that. It's too much danger to hurt
the piston rod. This is a Knipex, German called Knipex. It's not a spanner, it's a... Okay, you see it. And this special one has a button to fix the adjustment. And this is at this place very essential. But depends on you. So once again. Come on. Move. You need some skills, some craftsman skills to do this job, or let yourself help by an experienced friend. Show him this video. However, feel free to share this video, and if it was a help for you, may you give me a like for my channel. May you subscribe my channel. And if there are critics, please write in the comments. Give me comments to make my videos better. And don't forget the tape. Okay. The most critical part of the job seems to be done. Now, time for a cigar. And you see, with these new ceilings, you need a lot of force to move that thing. And now we're going to replace it. Not to replace it, we're going to assemble it back. I say again, be careful with your fingers and be careful with these lines. It's not a game, it's a rage game.
Mm-hmm.